So in our previous video, what we have seen is what is load balancing and what is the purpose of having multiple servers and applications are being hosted. Now, the ADC has to take a call based on what one of the cluster member is going to be chosen for forwarding the request, right? So that is what we call it as load balancing algorithms or load balancing methods. So depending on the vendor, the variety of methods would be available, the algorithms would be available. But regardless of those methods, they have been majorly classified into two. One is called a static, the other one is called as dynamic. Under static, we have a couple of load balancing methods like round robin and ratio based. Round robin, they don't consider the server performance at all. Whether the server is busy or not, I don't bother about it. I will be simply forwarding the request to it. Whereas the ratio, and it is also, they will be considering the server performance with respect to the capability defined by the administrator. We see those things one by one as we move forward. Under the dynamic, we have a couple of the methods like least connections, weighted least connections, fastest connections, I mean the fastest one, the least sessions, observed, predictive, and dynamic ratio. So various dynamic load balancing methods are there. So when I say static, it will not be understanding the current performance of the server. Based on some static values, the load balancing is going to be happening. Whereas the dynamic, they do monitor the performance of the server. According to the performance monitoring, they will be distributing the load to a different server dynamically. So maybe one of the server could be busy now, so the load has not been distributed to him. Because of the dynamic load balancing method continuously monitors that server, once the load has been reduced, obviously the new request can be forwarded to that server also. So that is what the main advantage of going for the dynamic load balancing. Whenever I talk about the dynamic load balancing, you can see that we know some of the informations are going to be collected from the node, or what is it called, the server. So the statistics, whatever you collect from those applications, you can based on that, you can take a call whether this server is overloaded or underloaded. If it is overloaded, I may not be sending the request to that particular server. So I need some set of information to be collected from the server. So that is what we will be talking about as what? Node versus member. So while I do the performance monitoring, I can collect the statistics, and then those statistics can be assigned for taking a load balancing or for assigning the load to a different member. So when I do collect the statistics, I have the option of collecting the statistics as a node or also as a member. The difference between node and member we already know. What is a node? Node is nothing but an IP address through which a server could be identified. Whereas the pool member or the member is nothing but the IP address plus the port number. So the key difference between these two is what? I'm going to be applying a load balancing method according to the performance of the node or according to the performance of the member. For example, if I have a server with multiple applications hosted on it, assume that I have a server with HTTP, FTP, and Telnet, right? So the HTTP server may be collecting some of the requests, handling some of the requests. FTP server can be handling some of the requests. Telnet may also be having some of the connection being handled. When I do monitor and apply the load balancing method according to the node, the collective statistics is what going to be taken. Assuming that I'm going to be choosing a server which has minimum number of connections. If I say that according to the node's minimum number of connection, it will consider all three applications connection, right? So if I say pool member, the pool member is nothing but that specific application's perspective, all right? So according to your requirement, you can take a call to apply the load balancing method according to the performance of the node or statistics collected from the node or according to the pool member, right? So this is what the load balancing methods and applying a load balancing can be based on the performance of the node or can also be based on the performance of the member. Now let's go ahead and move on to the different types of load balancing methods and how they are going to be applied and how they work.